You're watching Emanuela's Adoption Story Part 11.
Say 11.
Okay, I think we have all of our paperwork together that we need. James just went over to print one more thing, and now we're going to go to the medical appointment, because apparently we don't have to pick up a packet from the embassy. So they said just go in and do it. So that's something that we can get out of the way today, and we told Adam, like, we need the documents today because we have an appointment for Thursday. Oh my gosh, we're Thursday. Okay, we're freaking out. It's like in the back of my mind, I know that they print visas on Fridays, but I mean, I can't imagine that happening that quickly. So we're thinking like maybe next week. We might be leaving next week. Okay, anyways, James is over there at school. Will is getting her shoes on.
How you doing? How are you?
Good.
Good.
Foot.
You got a fork. Mmm. You take a bite.
Lift your head.
There we go. Okay, thank you. Just got home. Pretty painless. Well, except for Wella, because she had to do the TB test. Come over here. Yeah, so apart from having to go back and forth from all the rooms in the hospital, it was pretty good. And the TB test results aren't going to be ready until Thursday, so we're going to go to the interview, and then after the visa interview, we'll go back to the hospital, get the test results, and then take them back to the embassy. So it'll be fine. Apparently, this happens all the time. We're going to call my mom now and tell her. She has no idea.
Hello!
Good morning!
Hi, are you feeding your fish? Are you feeding your...
Yes, I was.
Are they happy to have clean water? Well, guess what? What's happening? Can you hear me?
Can you see who's on my lap?
Am I delayed?
I can't tell. I don't think so. I homeschooled you as best I could.
Okay, well, we have a visa interview scheduled for this Thursday.
What? Oh my gosh! What? Oh, that was amazing!
And guess where we just got back from?
We just got back from doing the medical appointment.
You did?
Yep.
You did it already?
Yep. While you were sleeping.
Show her the arm. Wella wants to show her the arm.
She had to get her TB test. Show Grammy. You can't see anything.
Right.
But it's on there.
Hang on.
Poked with the needle, but she didn't cry. She was very...
She didn't cry?
She was very brave.
I'm looking at it right there.
Wow!
This Thursday.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, I just got an email. Miss Wilson, we'll put you on the schedule for Thursday, May 31st. I just got the email. Are you filming that? It just came in. It just came in. And then it says Emanuela's case number. They're going to tell us the case number. So it's for sure. It's for sure. They might print a visa for us on Friday. Or they might tell us that they don't know when they're going to print it. We don't know. But they could say they're going to print it on Friday. That'd be pretty crazy. I gotta keep editing the documentary frantically.
Speaking of.
Oh
Yeah, I'm getting everyone's.
Oh, there's the video camera.
It has begun. We don't know where we're, what's happening with our lives, so that's exciting. We're either moving over to the Lance house on Sunday, or staying here because they might move into this house, or we might be going back to America. We don't know.
Hey.
Hi.
It's Wednesday, May 30th. So, we had another email from the embassy this morning. We have to log in to the National Visa Center website, but we can't log in because we're missing like a number to log in with. And since we did everything in Ghana, filed everything in Ghana, we didn't get these numbers to log in. And we have to log in because we have to fill out this form, and the National Visa Center gives us like this receipt, and we have to take the receipt to our interview. We're trying to figure out how to do that. And no one really knows, because most people do everything on the U.S. side of things, and the U.S. is dealing with it. We did all of our paperwork here. So I don't know if they're going to let us still have our appointment tomorrow. So that's kind of depressing. I emailed our travel agent who's been helping us this whole time. Maybe best case scenario, you might be able to come home this weekend, but what else do you need from us? And he said, well, I got flights for you on hold for Sunday. And I was like, whoa, okay, that's moving a little fast. It's just depressing because it's like the perfect flight. Anyways, I feel kind of depressed. We let ourselves get too excited, and now, you know, I don't think the embassy is going to be able to get that number that we need by tomorrow, and we have to have that. On top of that, we're still waiting for Edom to get us our documents. He's trying to get her birth certificate, the original. So we're trying to figure out if we can even get that today, because if we don't have the documents, then we don't have everything we need to go to the interview. And then on top of that, our adoption agency is like, when can you pay? When can you pay? You need to pay your remaining $2,000. And we said, well, we're happy to pay when we have all of our documents from your employee, Edom. And we're trying to get out of paying the full $2,000 because they sent us a breakdown of the fees, and over half of the stuff that we were going to pay them to do for us, which, you know, they pay Edom, like, we did it ourselves. So that's not fair for us to have to pay the full amount when we had to pay out of pocket for everything. So anyways, we're trying to see if they'll negotiate with us so we don't have to pay the full $2,000. Okay, we just got another email. So we already emailed the embassy this morning asking how...
2 hours ago.
I already explained we need this online form and we can't log in. So now they just emailed again, an expedited immigrant visa
interview.
So they're confirming, this is like our
right,
appointment
we're gonna print
letter.
This letter to the U.S. Embassy greeter at the time of the review.
A few minutes ago, I was just saying how we might have to cancel our interview.
No, it looks like we're still going.
Okay, we're still going.
And then down here, please visit.
Right. That's where we can't log in. Okay, so are they going to respond to the other email now and tell us?
Or should we send the email again?
No, I think, so they sent this as a separate email. There's nothing else attached.
Right.
Oh, no, all this. Maybe they're just going to figure it out when we get in there. Who knows? Well, I like that they use the word expedite.
As previously stated, again, we've been here, like, in every email.
Over 1.5 years. So does that how we got our expedite?
Maybe.
Or do they say that to everyone?
To keep them happy? I don't know.
All right, calling Edom for the first time this morning. We've already messaged him. I haven't heard anything. I really hope. Yeah. Is this Facebook Messenger? Is he active?
He's active now. Okay. Edom, hello, good morning.
Good morning, how are you?
I'm fine, how are you?
When can I meet him?
I'm okay.
Good, good. Hey, I was wondering, when can we pick up the documents from you today?
I think you guys are in touch with Kevin, right?
No, we're in touch.
No, we are in touch with you.
No, you've been in touch with Kerry. Kerry told me you guys are in touch. So, handle with it. I think you should deal with Kerry then, and later.
We need the documents today because we have an interview tomorrow. You are the one that is giving us the documents, so we are just dealing with you.
No problem, but you've been dealing with Kerry, you understand? So you've been dealing with Kerry for now because I've been busy doing something else. So you deal with Kerry and if you deal with her,
Adam, I understand what you're saying, but you need to listen to me right now. Sir, I know that you are busy. I know that Kerry says that you have been sick. We are supposed to be dealing with Kerry as well as you.
We're not getting the documents from Kerry.
Sir, Kerry's not giving us our documents. You're the one that has the documents. Why should we ask her to ask you to give us our documents?
Why not?
We are in the same country. We are in the same soil. Adam, come.
It doesn't matter.
I don't understand what you're saying. You are holding our documents and you are saying that she must tell you to give them to us?
That is not what she
said.
Why
did you not just give them to us?
She
has said
us
that you are going to give them to us as soon as possible.
She told us to call.
If you are available to give them to us now, then that would be as soon as possible. Do not make this more difficult than it needs to be when we are this close to the end, please. You are on our side and we know that.
Why would he say that? He's not gonna give us what we want, I don't think, babe.
No, he's not.
I think he's gonna make this as difficult as possible.
The number you called is not answering. The number you called is busy. Please.
I think he restarted his internet.
I don't know. So you deal with Kerry, and if I hear from Kerry, whatever I hear from Kerry, I'll let you know.
But here's the thing. There is a big time difference. I know that you would never say anything bad about us, and we are all on the same side. But I would like to remind you that you have told us in the past that you have done everything you could to communicate with us. You have done everything you can to communicate with us, but you leave us hanging for days. Listen to what I am saying right now. You have left us hanging for days with no communication, and now, tomorrow, we have an interview. And whether or not Kerry gives you a green light to give us our documents, this is something that we require from you. Now, we are in the same country. Now, I am assuming we are in the same city. Now, Kerry is sleeping. Now, this is something we need. Now, I am on your side. You are on my side. By the grace of God, we are going to get through this. I know. But I am anxious. I am stressed. And you can alleviate that stress for me now. So what are you going to do about it?
Okay, good. You are stressed. I don't think I am stressed. I think you don't value the role I have played. That is how I feel. And no, because I'm not a child. I'm a little bit older than you.
Yes.
So,
I would like to deal with you. I would prefer to deal with you. Because you have done so much for us. You have done so many things to precede us. How come you are taking steps backwards right now? We have lived in your compound. Why are you stepping back? We are already more connected to you than we are with Kerry. We've never met Kerry. Kerry lives in a different state than us. We've met you. We've had conversations with you.
Help us. Help Emanuela.
You know all this, but you went ahead to deal with her. So you go ahead and deal with her. If I hear from her, you said that it's going to be stressful. So you go ahead and deal with her. Don't
Okay. I hear what you're saying. Carrie will tell you. She will give you the green light. When she does, you will give us our documents. That's wonderful. Can you tell me what you have to give us?
What I have is what I have to give. What do you have?
Uh-huh. So you have the social welfare report?
What I have at my possession.
First person to know that we need updates. Do you remember when you took me to the airport? The first thing I said to you when I was leaving, I said, my wife needs updates from you. We need communication. You do not want to give communication. It is okay. I will talk to Carrie. Carrie will talk to you. We will get what we need from you if you have it, and everyone will be happy. We can say that we are very bad at things. If we choose not to be good at them, then we will always be bad at them. We can always get better at everything. We can always become better communicators.
Thank you for
everything. Thank you very much for everything that you are doing.
Adam, thank you.
You have made this happen. You. You are the one that is making everything happen for us. And we are very grateful for everything that you are doing.
Thank you.
Amen.
Thank you. Say thank,
thank you very much.
What?
Well, before we can do the final step, blah, 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 we need this money, then that's what it's all about. I won't do anything unless you give me the phone number and tell me if there's anything you want me specifically to say. But if you have me just make the call, I'm the concerned mother saying,
right.
I am hearing that Adam is not giving them their last documents and their appointment. Is coming up.
Right.
Now, how do we get him to do this? What is it you need to do? He has got to give them those papers today.
Yeah.
Now, what is it that needs to be done?
I think he's just stalling because he doesn't have them. And the things that he was saying, I mean, it's all recorded and on video. I don't like communicating. You just talk to Carrie. Just talk to Carrie. And James, it was... Yeah, I've never seen James talk to anyone like that, and it was so overwhelming because James was so firm with him. Okay, my mom just had the idea to call the hotel because maybe Adam has already taken our documents there and he's just giving us the runaround so that we can be stressed out.
So we're gonna see, calling.
So James is calling the hotel. We'll see.
Hello?
Hello,
good afternoon. This is James Wilson. Adam has told me that he was going to leave some documents at the front desk for me. Has he done it?
This who?
Come again?
I didn't get what you said. You said this is...
Oh, this is... It sounds like your phone is too close to a computer speaker. I'm getting some feedback.
This is not the hotel.
Hello.
Just say it again.
Yeah, it is a hotel. Who are you looking for?
Adam.
This is James Wilson. Adam told me he was going to leave some documents for me at the desk. Has he done it yet?
Yeah, he did.
He is there, yes, but did he leave the documents at the desk?
Yes.
Yes, they're there. Okay, wonderful. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Have a nice day.
Oh my gosh. No way.
I'm gonna eat this and I'll go get them. There's so much uncertainty to the matter for me.
What'd you find out? Anything?
The woman at the front desk said our documents are there.
And she also said that Adam is there.
So you had a really brilliant idea.
But I don't know I don't know for 100% certain that she really understood the question I was asking.
You asked it two times, though. You said, literally, and I have it on video. Oh, we'll wait for him to say you can get them, and then we'll say, oh, we already got them this afternoon. Thank you.
Or, with my luck...
James is a little worried.
With my luck, I'll see him in passing, and he'll have the documents in his hand because reception will have told him that I called.
But I don't think they will.
You know what? Either way...
And then you can just punch him in the face and take the documents.
Yeah, once you knock him down...
Oh, my word. I'm so glad you suggested that.
Well...
Oh, my word.
I don't know. I guess, since you were saying, he did this last time and they were right there, you know what I mean? So...
Wow, I cannot believe it. We're not going to tell Carrie either. She might be in on it. My mom just prayed with us. So that was good. We've been praying all day just to know what to do and have wisdom. And this is...
Bye. What?
Your cute little voice. I just checked my email and the embassy sent us a new... number to log in to do this online form. So, I'm gonna try that. Yep. And they said they'll see us tomorrow. You know, James went to the hotel. He just messaged me. The front desk told him that 20 minutes before he got there, Adam went and got the documents back. So they aren't there.
How's it going?
Adam took the documents back. The front desk said 20 minutes before James got there.
Are you kidding?
He went and got them. I said, how could Adam possibly know? And James said, he has my phone. So he said that Carrie saw our most recent message 30 minutes ago, and then 20 minutes ago, Adam took the documents. Is that a coincidence? Our message didn't say anything like we're trying to find Adam or anything like that, but Carrie, maybe she told him to hang on to them personally.
He's not gonna go try to find Adam and get him?
He can't. Adam wasn't at the hotel. James asked, and they said no. He took the documents and left.
I think I need to call Carrie. Find out why.
Okay, my mom is calling Carrie to see, because Carrie read our message and hasn't responded. And our message to her was what happened with our conversation with Adam and how he said that he's waiting for a green light from her or whatever. Adam just Facebook messaged. I can see it on my computer. He said, James, I am human. Any news from the agency? Oh, you are human? Oh, okay. I said, yeah, Carrie said you would get our documents to us today. We are waiting for you to tell us when. James should be here in like 50 minutes. Adam's typing. Oh, my word. I don't want to be doing this right now. Oh, my goodness. And the number. Tell her to contact me. Okay. No way. No way. Oh, my word. After all we've been through, it comes down to money. We should have known. I need James to get home. Carrie says all the documents are ready. We're still waiting for the final fees to be paid. So sorry for the delay. That is so disappointing and sad. The last money that we owe is like our only hope that they're gonna keep helping us so we don't... Oh, good, Babo, you're here. Babe-o.
Is that sad or joy?
It was Carrie. She's telling Adam to withhold them until we pay. She is backstabbing us. So what, are we just gonna pay it? Good afternoon, I sent you an email just a little while ago. All the documents are ready. We're still waiting for the final fees to be paid. So sorry for the delay. It's all come down to this.
Okay, we got a receipt.
I went through. Okay, screenshot the receipt. I'll send it to her. People have warned us about Carrie.
Just feels sickening to know that for this entire 1.5 year process, all of the stress that we've felt surrounding Edom and all of the times that we have been cursing and just like, what is happening, Edom, what is wrong with you? All of that angst was supposed to be directed at Carrie because she was the one telling him to withhold documents. She was the one telling him that if he wants to get paid, then he can't give us everything until the very end. And now here we are, the near end of the process, a day before our visa exit interview. It's just sickening because we've harbored so much negativity and resentment towards Edom, who is...
He's saying, hold on, I said, you've done more for us than Carrie or anyone else. Thank you for all you've done for us and Emanuela. He says, I don't think so. You have done more. Carrie just messaged and said, Edom's friend is going to bring the documents to us. So what we just paid for, Edom isn't even doing it. Some person who we don't know is going to be handling our classified important documents.
I'm going to call him right now.
Okay, do it.
Hello, good afternoon. My name is James Wilson. What is your name? Come again?
What is it?
I've been told by Edom to meet you.
I'm coming. I'm coming.
Are you coming to East Legon? ANC Mall?
No, F1 here.
Okay, can you come to East Legon?
No,
okay, so the airport shell. Okay, what vehicle are you driving? A white vehicle.
Ask what time.
Okay, what time will you be there?
Are you there now?
Okay. I have also encountered some traffic, so I will be some minutes. How long do you think it will take you? Just so that I have an idea. Okay, wonderful. Well, I will come as soon as I can, and I will call you when I arrive, okay?
Thank you
very much, sir.
Bye.
Bye-bye. Okay. Just called him.
No, don't tell her. Don't update her. Who's that? Hewick? Wella? And who else? Who's that?
Lena.
Yeah, it's me! James went to go meet with this friend.
Meet.
Thanks, baby. Thank you. Thank you. You're so sweet. Okay. Thank you. You're being so silly. Oh. Okay, now I think you're just showing off.
All right. So after waiting So after waiting for 45 minutes,
yeah,
the guy shows up, parks across the parking lot, so I have to walk to him. Walk to him, get there, hands me the thing, and shakes his hand, you know. Thank you very much, sir, I really appreciate it. Have a good day. Oh, Adam said that you should give me 50 Ghana.
Oh, no. Lie, obviously.
And I said, actually, no, I think he said that he was going to take care of it. Thank you, thank you. Have a wonderful day.
Oh, my gosh. Yeah, no. Adam asked his friend, we're not going to pay for it. So is this it right here?
It's all of it.
You look?
I said, this is everything that he gave you, correct? He said, yes, yes.
Okay, gotta go through it. Okay.
Department of Social Welfare, okay.
Is that the inquiry?
I don't know. This is like statement. This is all our stuff. Social inquiry report. Here's the original.
Just pulled this out. It's her original birth certificate.
And her original name. Let's look at the back of it.
What we needed. Nothing awkward on it. No invalid or anything.
All right, so...
Oh, my word. And
we got two birth certificates.
Okay, so it looks like we have everything. Wow. Wow. Took a lot of effort.
Now all of you need to do is figure out how to do the DS-260.
Right, the online thing. It's still not working. I was filming, like, the embassy. They sent us an in. It's, yeah, still not working.
So we're going to take care of it in person tomorrow?
I guess. I don't know. Now we just have to make photocopies of all of this stuff. All
right.
Okay, so we've been organizing our paperwork. We have everything that it says we for sure need. And then we have a whole bunch of other documents that we're going to take in the car with us.
Minus the DS-260 because their website doesn't let us on.
Minus that one that we keep talking about.
Yeah, the application for this thing that we're going to do. The thing that says that we're there.
So, got our paper. Why is this blurry? So, anyways, we're feeling pretty organized, pretty ready. Do you think we're going to bring the video camera? We probably should bring
it. Yeah, so that when we get in the car and we're on the way to the medical
our
place.
Our friend Albert is going to pick us up, so that's really nice. He's an Uber guy, an Uber friend that we made friends with, like, a lot of months ago. And so that makes it really easy. We can leave our stuff in the car with him, and so that's kind of a big, like, relief. Because you can't take your phone or bags into the embassy.
Although they have a security area where they can hold things, they've decided not to hold things anymore. Can you hear me that?
So... Okay, so we feel ready. We have our clothes laid out. We have our breakfast prepared. James and I are going to walk down the road and get a few more snacks.
And then we're going to come back.
I just can't believe that I can't believe that we're here. It's happening. We have our documents.
A lot of this.
We just got the login to work. This is so random. I literally just found this paper.
From 2 years ago. After we filed our I-600A.
I don't know. It was just sitting, and it has this number.
The NVC.
It's a different number than the one they told us to use.
The number is different by one.
Anyways, we're logged in now.
Yeah, here we are. We're going
to
start.
So we're going to fill it out, and then we have to find a place to go print it. It's like 7:45 p.m., so. James, this is everything we need. If we can fill this out successfully.
I know.
Oh, my goodness. Okay,
here we go.
Okay. Daddy's got breakfast.
Fire! Fire!
I'm so nervous. Wella. We're having lunch for breakfast. Confused.
Today is a day full of potential. Even if we receive bad news, it'll be good news because it'll be news, and we'll be moving forward.
One step closer.
Yeah.
It'll be disappointing, but we'll get through it. We'll find the positive, like we always do.
This one can't help but find the positive. Look at her. Eat her.
Eat, Zilly. Eat.
Eat her. Eat your food.
Feeling nervous?
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Nervous. Excited.
Because, like, it's... Our first potential experience meeting with a potential American. and just gonna sit down.
Being this close.
Okay.
Oh, Heavenly Father.
Yeah, let's pray together.
We're just asking you to go with us today as we go and meet with these people at the embassy. They hold our immediate future in their hands, and we just ask that you have your angel sitting next to them, prompting them to make what needs to happen for us tomorrow so that we can go home on Saturday. We're hopeful and we're faithful that this might be one of your possible plans. So we just let us just come back here happy with good news to share with the world.
And give us peace.
And give us peace with whatever outcome we have.
And wisdom to say the right words. Mm. Amen.
Amen.
Say amen.
Amen.
Okay, let's go.
That's life. Because once you have life, you're able to do so all the time.
Mm.
Yeah. And you bet more of the civil servants than the rich men.
Mm.
Where's the road, James?
I think it is this one. Or is it the next one?
Yeah, I mean, Adam parked there.
Okay.
We don't want to, or James, this is kind of a long ways to walk. Maybe
yeah,
we should go.
So yeah, we should, let's turn around and then,
we have time.
I don't think it's considered parking if you're still in the car, right?
But
let's go.
That's us. We're going to be waiting in line.
So we'll go to the right. And then on the other side here, there is
KSI 60.
Mm-hmm. Oh boy. Big line. Big line.
Room to spare.
Okay. Here we go. You ready, Willa? You ready?
As we go.
You ready, James?
Pray for us, please.
Today is going to be a fruitful day.
Thank
Don't
you.
Worry.
Thank you. We will see you in.
Just got home. The interview went great. We turned all our paperwork. They have everything, but they still told us that they have a little bit more review to do before they can issue a visa. She wasn't allowed to give a timeline, so I guess we're just back in limbo. More waiting.
But this review is a review of the investigation that has already been done.
Yeah.
All she has to do is discuss with other embassy officials there, as well as DHS back in America, documents that they've already collected. So it's not going to be as long as the actual investigation. Which was
because our investigation already happened, and she confirmed that.
It's done.
And she said, yes, we just have to match it up with our records, because that was USCIS, and now we have to do it with our... We just have to review it and make sure everything still looks good. Not exactly the result that we were hoping for, but we're just so tired, and the embassy is such a headache, and just waiting for 5 hours.
How long were you waiting to see her the first time?
I think 5 hours.
Yep.
Please stop. You can go upstairs. All right. Okay, I don't know. It's part of the plan. We're still kind of numb. We already had to tell people. I just sent out messages. I'm turning off my phone now. Can't even, don't want to talk to anyone. Don't want to deal with anything. Yeah, so. There you have it. June 1st.
June 1st.
Friday. So, I guess our heads are feeling a little bit clearer than they were yesterday. Just like emotionally drained, and right now we're just very focused on, you're eating your paper towel. You're literally eating your paper towel. You gotta roll it down.
I'll show you.
We just have our emotional wall up because we have to get through this time. We haven't cried this morning. We've been working on an email to the head of Nightlight and Carrie's boss, explaining what happened and how, you already know everything that happened. Just asking them to reimburse us. We have our receipts and everything.
Very detailed email, and
we're still just,
if we get rejected, then it'll be like, at least we tried, but.
And get this, Adam is asking us for the documents back. Yeah. Do we want to say anything that happened else yesterday? Because we didn't really give any details. We waited for how many hours?
Okay.
We
waited 4.5 hours.
Just to talk to someone.
Just to talk to
someone. We waited in line outside.
Mm-hmm.
Then we got to go inside. Then we waited for, 4 hours for our name to get... Well, we went up, we turned in some documents, and then we waited 4 hours for our lady to get there. The lady who was doing the interview,
an
she
American.
Had... Yeah, she was an American. She had an emergency or something. That's why I guess it took so long. We went up to her little window. The first American, it was so refreshing. She was just so nice. Everything that she was saying, she asked us these questions, but she just asked them in a kind way. Yeah, she was just very professional, but personable as well. Made us feel so good and relaxed that this American lady is now in charge of our case.
This is the first time we've ever felt like this in Ghana.
In a year and a half. But she couldn't give us a timeline. She said, I can't tell you anything. And we're like, okay, we understand. Like, legally, you can't.
But she did say we can email her as many times as we want.
Yeah, that was really nice.
And she'll always get back to us and don't feel like we're bothering them.
Mm-hmm. So, hold on. Okay, so...
It's just great because the last people that we were emailing at the embassy was USCIS. And the last email that we sent and received, the last correspondence that we had with them, it was like they were essentially telling us to screw off. But now someone's saying, you can email me as many times as you want,
yeah,
and I'll let you know how things are going.
Then we had to go get Wella's tuberculosis skin test checked and pick up the medical report and take it back to the embassy. So this nice lady at the embassy, she gave us this appointment, this piece of paper that would get us back into the embassy. So we jumped back in the car, we drove to Akai House, the clinic. They made us wait for an hour, mm-hmm. Did it end up being?
It was an hour.
Yeah, okay, an hour, maybe a little bit more, actually.
Thing that they should have been doing over the past 2 days, they did right when we got there to pick it up.
Okay, so we waited for that. Well, at this point, like, we had some snacks, but we were just so exhausted and just drained, and, like, we couldn't even process what we had just found out about the embassy, that, you know, we're not going home. We don't know when we're going home. Our drive back to the embassy... The guys, we waited outside in the sun for 30 minutes. They wouldn't let us in. They just lump us in with everyone else. Like, I guess, like, I understand it, but it still is kind of ridiculous that we have U.S. passports. We were just there to drop something off, and the guy was like, nope, 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 stay in line, stay in line. We're like, we just need to run up to the window and drop. No, 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 no. Stay in the queue. Stay in the queue. You have to sit in a certain spot. You can't, you know. So we're sitting there for about, so finally we get to go inside. We're sitting there for about 10 minutes, like, oh my gosh, this is ridiculous. And then James hears our lady's voice. She's calling.
The next person in queue.
She's like, says their name.
Blah, 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 blah. Sarah Croshia.
Comes.
Window 10.
Window 10. And James.
That's her.
Said, that's her. And you said, should I go drop off this at her window?
Should I go do what she said we should come do?
This poor old lady was trying to go to the window because it was her name that got called. So she's trying to walk to the window, and James just is like quickly walking past her. This old woman, she goes to the wrong window, and all the Ghanaians sitting down are like, no, 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 window 10, window 10. James just goes like zooming past her, goes up to window 10 where our lady is.
I said, oh, please, can I just drop this off? She said, oh, yes, please, just drop it off. Here, 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 take.
Mm-hmm. And then we got to leave, and everyone else was probably like, what? So James broke the rules, because you're not supposed to do that, because that's not the way things are. But James did it like a rebel, went up, dropped it at the window, and then we're like, all right, let's get the heck out of here. This guy who's supposed to be organizing, keeping the whole herd organized, and he was like, James is like, sir, we left it at the window. We left it at the window. We're going to go
you
now.
You can remove me from the queue, please.
And he was
you.
Like, hold on. And he ran away. And then, like,
5 minutes later, he comes back.
And he's like, okay, what were you saying? And James was like, I left it at the window. You can take us out of the queue. You don't need to call our name.
How do you mean?
In 45 minutes, when it's our turn and you call our name, we're not going to be there because we already did it. Okay? And then we just went, got in the car. Came home. Just trying to hold in the emotion, I guess. We have to keep our wall up more than ever because we're not going to survive if we let ourselves feel fully the disappointment and agony. In other news, I guess, the Lances are moving over their stuff today. So we've been kind of organizing and getting our stuff all contained, and they're going to start bringing their stuff over. Not sure when. We don't plan to have any further communication with Carrie. I'm not so upset about the money. I'm upset about the way that she handled it, and it feels like she blackmailed us, and she used our documents as leverage.
Right. She leveraged us during a period when
that
she
was
knew
so stressful.
We were stressed.
So you were there for that whole thing. Mm-hmm. So I can't even. She's been asking, how did the interview go? Like, acting like everything's fine. And I'm just, not responding to her, so I can't. I literally can't. I cannot talk to her right now. Anyways, welcome to the month of June.
Wow. Whoa. Wow. Oh. Whoa. Hey, is that fun? It is? Okay. Is that why you're still doing it? Interesting. Wow. Whoa. Whoa. Hey, whoa. Whoa. Hey, whoa. Oh, yep. Take a drink. All right. Wave at the camera. Say bye. And you got water in your mouth. Swallow, then say bye.
Bye.
We sent our email to Dan, director of Nightlight, and Lisa, who is Carrie's supervisor. Carrie keeps messaging, what happened? How did it go? And we're just like ignoring her. We have a message to send to her as well at some point when we feel up to it. So in like maybe an hour or so, my mom is going to try calling Dan directly to just kind of hammer in what we said in the email and just, you know, directly talk to.
Like, come and deliver it and then wait for her to knock and knock and knock and knock. Not answer the door. Wait for her to start to walk away. Then open the door and be like, oh, how can I help you? Did you need something?
Right. Okay, so the Lances have moved some other stuff over, it looks like. Kind of looks homey-ish now.
I burst of blood vessel in my
knuckle. Are you okay, people? Wella, you're not allowed to do that. Do not stick your head through the rail. Do you understand? No? Then you can go to your room. Oh, hi, you feel better now? Come over here, please. You don't put your head through the railing. You understand? Okay, good. Thank you. Okay, I'm gonna call her. Okay, we just got an email back from Dan. Kim is on another call. Kimberly! Get it together. We are number one here.
Stop.
Oh, talking to Papa. Oh, oh, oh. How can we help you at this time? Did you not see the six
words
to 12 paragraphs?
Reimburse, reimburse, reimburse.
I'm gonna give Daniel a call. We'll see how this goes. Probably it'll just go to his voicemail.
Yeah. Yeah.
Anyway. Okay. Anyways. I have a lot of stuff here, so.
Do you feel good about this? Do you feel confident? Do you think this is the right thing to do?
Sure. I don't think it can hinder us at this point.
I don't think it can hinder us either. As long as, like, we don't really need the agency, we don't really need Carrie, but we would like to be reimbursed, and we don't want to wait to deal with this till we get home because we need to deal with it now.
So if I have to leave a message, I should just give my name and number?
What do you think, babe?
Yeah, name, number, and
you're calling
in regards
to, for a few questions
regarding some adoption questions I have.
Yep, just keep it vague.
Yeah. Okay, so we just found out that Isaac has lice. They have to deal with that. Where are you going, babo? So James sprayed the stuff that they bought over with Heaven spray, and hopefully that kills whatever, if anything, you know, came over. And
so that house is filled with poison.
So we're kind of having a little bit of trouble breathing. Yeah, and then tomorrow they were gonna move over the furniture, so we just said, you know, put the furniture out in the sun because hopefully that'll kill everything before you bring it in. Because I think in the U.S., like, I don't know, but like you put all your like pillows and sheets and, all, and like you put that in the dryer, but we don't have anything like
right,
that.
Right, because it superheats it.
So we're just gonna put everything in the sun. My mom tried calling Dan and he wasn't at the office, so she left a message. And then I messaged Carrie. Oh man, watching the documentary back, because I talk about her like throughout it, and now we like know.
We're gonna be sitting watching the documentary with your parents and be like, she was probably backstabbing us right here, right here.
We can't even convey the way your actions have made us feel this week. You leveraged us using our documents during one of the most stressful times of this process.
To know that you did this on purpose while knowing that we've been through what we've been through, sorry. While knowing what we've been through is absolutely devastating.
What? Why are you laughing, James? This is serious.
Your face.
Alright. Keep reading.
We told Dan that we aren't comfortable sharing any information with you anymore. Any more information?
Whoa, they took it to the next level.
And he said we can include Lisa in all future correspondence.
Hi, Lisa. Welcome to the documentary. It's been a really busy day, but I think we did pretty good. What do you think, Bebo? Do you think we did good? We stayed very focused.
I think we did really good.
We got Joe finished up and invoiced it. Oh, we need to see if he's paid it.
So I said, it's just unbelievable after they paid, you know, $24,000 to you that they would think you would not get their final payment. It's shocking. We actually have to strong arm people into paying their final bill or we will not receive the money from them. He says there are tens of thousands of dollars that people don't pay us in the end because they are unsatisfied or ungrateful. He says, this is our experience. This is the way we have to do it, is we have to, you know, in a sense, strong arm people to pay. And I said, well, I think if Kaylee and James would have known that before they could receive their final documents, they just needed to pay their final
right.
Now,
we didn't
even would have been able to do that. But it was like their eyes were open in shock, I said, when Carrie finally essentially said that in the, you know, the night before their most important meeting, it's down to the hours, and they're just fretting over these documents and find out, guess what? You pay your money, you get your documents. And so I said that they were just shocked. It was unbelievable that they just felt so, I said it was so disturbing to them that even their own representative from this agency would do that to them because, you know, they felt like there was, you know, just a better relationship there than to be blackmailed for their money, kind of like, that's what it felt like to them. And then he said, well, they may be paying for the sins of the families that have gone before them is what is happening. And he says that that's... He said, it's not Carrie's fault. She's following the orders of our company. That's how we have to run it.
But she didn't have to do it exactly like that.
She could have told us in advance, just so you're aware, before you get your remaining original documents, you will need to pay the remaining fees. If she would have told us that a month in advance, then we would have been able to have this nice conversation with her about, okay, well, there are some things that we will need to have reimbursed before we do that.
Okay, so we started putting some other stuff they brought in yesterday out in the sun just so I can sit and kind of cook the lice. They're bringing over some more furniture to sit in the sun, which is great. We just want to take every precaution. It is worth it.
I'll get the broom.
Wait, it has the sound inside, so it's going to be heavy.
Alright, so you... Yeah.
Oh, nice.
How about I go first? Yeah. Got the longer legs, make it easy for you.
Okay.
From the heaven spray and the chemical. Even when I woke up this morning, it hurts so bad, like when I swallow. James just told me that I should take a shot of our mint flavored whiskey. So that sounds like a pretty good idea.
Shot.
I'm looking ratchet. You can tell how stressed out we are by how bad my hair looks. I've noticed that from editing 11 hours of the documentary.
So what is this, Bibo?
Menth. Water.
Menthol.
No, no, I'm just kidding. It's a menthol mint flavored liqueur. 100 proof, meaning 50% APV. It's difficult. It's like drinking Everclear. It's not fun.
Wow, that really takes the pain away. I can actually, but I'm talking right
it,
now.
It does what it needs to do. Bye.
Oh. Here, get on your stool.
Let's see if he's still out there. Oh my goodness. James is out there. Gracious.
No. It is June 7th, my 28th birthday. Can't believe it. And I spent my whole 27th year here. So crazy. And now this is my second birthday in Ghana. Okay, so not many things to update on, but I did get a cold over the weekend. I think from James spraying the the chemical heaven spray. You saw I couldn't like talk, and so that's kind of still, I think that turned into a cold. All weekend I was blowing my nose, still him, coughing, it turned into complete, yeah.
Hello.
Starting to feel better now though, it's Thursday, so. What, are you saying hi?
You're on the boat, Willa. Yeah. Good,
cheer up. Are you okay? Brush it off. I emailed the embassy this morning asking for, like, to ask if, you know, how things are going, if they need anything from us, and haven't heard back yet, but it has officially been a week since we went to our visa interview. So crazy, like, time goes by, like, fast. It's already been a week. The days go by slow, but time itself goes by fast. Risa contacted our person in the State Department again and sent them an email that our case has been transferred and we just need this review from the State Department. And the State Department wrote back yesterday and said they're working as quickly as they can to finish the processing for Emmanuel's case. So that felt like good encouragement. Relaxing today, pretty much like a normal day, but more movies, I guess. And all I wanted for my birthday was cereal. Like last year, I got cornflakes, so yeah, been enjoying that. We went out for lunch, or I should say James brought lunch here, so there's that. Anyways, it's been a good 28th birthday. Ay, mosquito.
What is happening?
This is gonna be loud. Just drilling through the wall.
Okay, I'm gonna go into the backyard. Well, if you want to call it a yard, I'm gonna look at what they were installing in the wall last night. Let's see what they put up here. Huh. Okay. Looks like they had a very productive work evening. They were meandering outside for about 3 hours. They managed to get 4 holes. Get her, Mama. Get her! Mama looks hungry.
No.
She's gonna take a bite out of Wella.
I hear some snot gurgling around this poor girl.
Where'd she go?
Mama.
I think she went into the bathroom. There.
Wait, really? It's a dish?
Yeah, they're setting up a dish that will reach the school, maybe. I don't know, it says DSTV on it.
Just dropped off this book. She brought it all the way from America. We're so excited. This is the book that Cody and I learned how to read with. So now we get to do it with Wella. Do you want to learn how to read? We're going to work every day for about 15 minutes. The work is hard, but I think you can do it. You're going to learn how to read like mama. Can you say,
You're so excited. You have to regulate your happiness.
Come back over here. We're learning how to read. Me. Say it fast.
Me.
Good.
Looks like they overcompensated a little bit on the size of the holes and they went a little bit too big. There's the finished product. I know exactly who you're talking about. Yes. Every single day. He needed a scooter to match his boombox. Oh, brother.
30 years old.
30 years old.
What time is it there? 3 a.m.?
Yeah, it's 3 a.m.
30 at 3 a.m.
So if we get, hey, you guys, if we get disconnected, call us on TJ's.
Okay.
Because my phone's at like 6-ish.
Okay.
Percent.
That's fine.
Because I did Ubers and shit.
The embassy just called. She said, come at 2 p.m. to the embassy, drop off her passport. And I said, when are they going to put the visa? And she said, we will try this week. But they want us to bring the passport. So that was the embassy, actually. They want us to come drop off Wella's passport.
Oh, my goodness.
So that they can put a visa in it. We just got back from the embassy. That was quick. We're only gone like an hour. Turned in her passport. It was actually really, really simple. And
they presented us with this.
They gave us this, which says, come back on Thursday to pick it up. To pick up her visa on Thursday. I feel like I can't believe it. Like, I'm not really processing it. I don't really know.
I just can't. I can't be excited yet. Until we're leaving the embassy with it in our hand, and we know for a fact that we got it in 2 days, 2 days from now, that we have it in our hand, nothing has changed for me. And that's really hard to deal with, because I want to be excited, but I also know what it feels like to be excited.
Right.
And then
that happened to us
so many times.
Recently. Anyways, I think we're going to put flights on hold. We got to talk to our families and see. We're just tired. We're so tired, and it's hard to have the energy to get our hopes up again. That we are coming back to pick up the visa on Thursday.
Yeah. Oh no.
So. So worst case scenario, like you said, they.
They don't print it Thursday, they print it Friday.
They print it Friday because something happens.
Or Tuesday, or Wednesday, or Thursday,
right.
Or Friday. We're either coming home this weekend or next weekend. For sure.
Right. It's happening. So I think we can let ourselves
feel.
Feel. It's just so scary. But we should. We're gonna. You're done? Okay. We're gonna get excited. I gotta finish the documentary.